Here comes Sparkles. Here comes Sparkles.
No, what's going on?
Whoa, hang on.
This is awful. Terrible. Who was that guy?
And there's no such thing as white pumpkins.
That's the white pumpkins hanging all over the place.
I really don't like it. Man, poor Captain Sparkles.
Yeah, trapped by sand. That's a rough way to go.
Yeah, super rough. And I'm not gonna be next. I'm out of here.
So much for a nice dinner party.
So we're stuck in here. And if we're stuck in here, we're all doomed.
I thought I heard Sparkle say something about a flint and steel.
Oh, please don't bring that up again.
Well, obviously Talk Dog didn't steal it.
Okay, but who then?
Jesse?
Well,
Ivor's next.
I guess I'm next then.
Nope, not happening.
Yeah, basically, I'm.
Don't worry, Ivor. I'll protect you.
I appreciate that, Jesse. I just hope that this white pumpkin isn't beyond both of our abilities.
Well, I'm sure there's a perfectly logical explanation for how the white pumpkin is doing all this. I mean, the whole place has got to be rigged with traps, right? Torque Dog, trap. Sparkles. Trap.
Yeah. We need to find out what makes these traps tick. All right. I'm going to investigate that dining room.
Cool. I'll keep those guys in the hall for now so I can keep an eye on everyone.
An excellent idea. Don't want them messing up the crime scene.
I'm sticking with you, Jesse. Doesn't seem safe to wander off alone.
Okay, people, clear out! This is a crime scene!
What?
Okay. How are you doing this, white pumpkin? How you holding up?
You mean after seeing a guy get crushed under a ton of sand? Yeah, I'm definitely a little shaken up. We need to figure out who's doing this. And how.
Well, keep your eyes open. Between the two of us, I'm sure we'll be able to figure it out.
Sounds good to me.
This looks like the exact spot where the white pumpkin appeared. But now, just a portrait. Unless...
Damn.
It's just a costume on an armor stand with a jukebox for a voice. No sign of how it was triggered.
Wow. The white pumpkin must have some amazing redstone skills to rig up something like this. But why? It must have taken a lot of work to rig up.
I think it was to scare us. A warning.
Well... Mission accomplished.
Oh. You're not gonna like make me examine? Oh, here we go. What the hell?
Okay, so this was the dining table where we were all gathered together right before... Okay, let's give this a shot.
just like before.
Greetings, adventurers. I am the White Pumpkin.
Yep.
Wow. One of
just
you
like
is
before.
The treasure I desire, and I will not rest until it is mine, even if I have to resort to murder.
Jesse!
He's back! The White Pumpkin's back!
Don't worry, everyone. It's just a dummy. A White Pumpkin costume on an armor stand.
Wait, what? Why?
The trap that killed Sparkles. The whole show with the White Pumpkin. It was all triggered by a button on the table.
But what does that mean?
I am so creeped out right now.
Understandably.
It means that the White Pumpkin sat at this very table and pushed the button.
Wait, so you're saying that the White Pumpkin is one of us?
That's right, Mr. Stampy. One of us is a murderer.
And he sat right here.
Great timing.
Wait, but that's not where Jesse found the button before.
There's more than one?
I'll see if I can find all of them.
Nice work, Jesse.
Yes, I must say I'm relieved to know that there's a logical explanation for what the White Pumpkin's been doing.
So what now? Feels like we've made some good progress so far, though, right?
We need to figure out the most likely suspects and interrogate them. Judging by the tipped arrows and these traps, the White Pumpkin must have some serious chops in brewing and redstone.
Okay, that's all of them.
If you could all please take the same seat you were at before. Four of your seats are marked. These are the seats that had a button to activate the trap. That means that the White Pumpkin could only be Dan, Stampy, Lizzie, or Lucas.
Wait, you're accusing us? Wait, what?
I echo their sentiments exactly. I didn't even see a button.
Hey, I'm not accusing anyone. Yet.
It sure sounds like you're accusing us, stranger. And I don't care for it.
I'm taking charge now. And I'm going to get to the bottom of this. I want everyone separated. I'm going to talk to each suspect one by one so I can find out who's telling the truth and who's lying. I've got a whole lot of questions, and I want nice little matching answers for each and every one of them. Understand me?
Loud and clear.
Yes, crystal clear.
Who are you gonna interrogate first?
Lizzie.
Damn. Some FBI shit going on here.
Jesse, listen. There's been a lot of talk thrown around today. I don't know what people have told you. I don't know what you believe. But I'll just admit it. I want that enchanted flint and steel as much as anyone. Probably more than any of them. I've been searching for it for years. Do you know how much it stung to have Dan, swoop in and take it from under my nose?
Hang on. I thought you said you found it.
Well, I as good as found it. I did the research, I did the studying, I was all prepared to go in there and finally get it when that little goggle-wearing goon swept in and stole it first. Listen, I just want to get out of here and get on with my day. What do you have to hear to be convinced that the White Pumpkin isn't me?
Know what this is?
Tipped arrow. Kinda shoddy work, though. Definitely not one of mine, if that's what you're wondering. Some noob made that thing. Stampy asked me once about how to make those. Could be one of his. Plus, I taught Cassie and Stacy how to make those a while back.
I'm just gonna be straight. Who do you think stole the flint and steel?
Well, it wasn't me, if you're curious. If I had an enchanted flint and steel, I'd be off exploring some other world with it. But me and Dan have been competing to find that thing for years. You're looking for a likely culprit? I'd look at that guy.
I'll keep that in mind. You like using redstone? Ever make traps with the stuff?
I'm fine, I guess. I can make lights and doors and stuff. You want to do advanced stuff? You gotta talk to Stampy. He was the tri-block champion.
Huh. Tri-block champion?
Yeah, like 2 or 3 years in a row, if I recall correctly.
Thanks for your time, Lizzie. That's all for now.
Who's up next?
Send Stampy in here.
Right.
Hello! That was, Lizzie on her way out, right? Listen, I don't know what she told you, but... Jesse, I'm telling you, this is just crazy! Absolutely crazy! Total misunderstanding! I don't even want that flint and steel thingy! Not, as much as the others, at any rate. Did I hear someone saying that it has something to do with portals? I don't have any interest in portals. No, sir. Not for old Mr. Stampycat, thank you. It's me, Stampy! Everyone's friend!
I gotta say, Stampy, you seem... nervous. Everything okay? You comfortable?
What? No, I'm not nervous. Nope, totally comfortable. I could fall asleep right here, right now. I'm that comfortable, honestly. Please, just tell me what you want to know.
Know anything about this?
Oh, wow! What is that? Some sort of magic arrow? No, I've never seen anything like it before. Honest. Dan could probably tell you something, though. He loves weapons and all of that.
Oh my god. Here we go.
Okay, enough dancing around. Who do you think took the flint and steel?
I don't think it was ever actually stolen.
Oh?
Yeah, so Dan got it ahead of Lizzie, right? And she was pretty angry about it. I think he made up that story about it being stolen so she'd think he didn't have it anymore. Classic Dan move.
What do you know about redstone? What's your skill level with the stuff?
Oh, well, you know, about average? Average level? Moderate? I don't know how these things are graded these days.
That's funny. I heard from Lizzie that you were the Tri-Block champion.
Who? Me? Oh, what a lark. No, no, no. She must be mistaken. I know that Dan's been getting really into the stuff lately, though. Just putting that out there, in case you're curious.
You're excused, Stampy. Thank you for your time.
Oh, thank goodness. This room's making me very nervous.
Right,
not that it's any of my business, really, but make sure you ask Dan about that flint and steel. He's got quite the history with it.
Ready for Dan?
Yeah. Send him in.
Hey, I don't know what the other's been saying, but you have to listen. I'm telling you, you've got the wrong guy. Honest. I would never hurt anyone. You've got to believe me. If anyone's been wronged here, it's me. That enchanted flint and steel everyone's talking about? I found that. That's mine. At least it was before someone stole it. And now everything's gone completely crazy. People getting caught in horrible traps, everyone accusing and blaming each other.
Exactly, he wants the revenge, right?
This flint and steel means a lot to you, doesn't it?
You don't get it. Lizzie and I have been chasing each other to get that thing for years. And now people are dying because of it? I just want you to know the truth. I'm not the White Pumpkin. You've got to believe me. What can I tell you to convince you?
Yeah, show him there.
Know anything about this?
Oh, wow. No, I've never seen anything like that before.
No? Tipped arrows not ringing a bell? Made using potions.
Nuh-uh, but you want to know about stuff with potions? I've asked Lizzie. She's way better with that stuff than I am. I always go to her with potion questions.
I was just talking to her.
So, how would you rate your redstone knowledge?
Me? Whew, not much. Not really my scene. You want to know more about that stuff? You should ask Stampy. He was the Tri-Block champion.
Yeah. 3 years in a row, according to Lizzie.
There, you see? He's the only one here who could have built such amazing traps.
Out with it! Who stole the flint and steel?
I don't know. I don't know anything about it.
And you just expect me to believe that? Seems to me that your name's been coming up connected to that flint and steel a lot today.
Maybe Stampy's the White Pumpkin?
But I want to ask, do you think the White Pumpkin is Stampy Cat?
Yeah, actually, yeah, I do. With the costume and the crazy games, it's got Stampy Cat written all over it.
More like Squid Games.
You can go now, Dan.
Thanks, Jesse. Thank you.
Oh, come on! This is nuts!
You had a button, too! Fair's fair. It's your buddy's turn next.
Wait, Lucas, really? Get the hell out of here.
Hey, Jesse.
Ah, my final suspect. Here to point more fingers and blame more people, I'm sure.
I didn't push the button, you know.
I figured. Thanks, though.
How's it been going in here? It is just non-stop whispering and rumors out there. Me, Petra, and Ivor pretty much been sticking to ourselves.
So hard to say. I mean, the way they keep throwing each other on the minecart tracks, it's like they're all guilty.
Well, if there's one person who can untangle it, it's you.
Thanks, Lucas. Come on, suspect. It's time to return to the others.
So? Have you decided?
Yes. Who do you think the White Pumpkin really is?
Now, hang on, everyone. First of all, I want to thank everyone for answering my questions. There's still not 100% proof of anyone, but...
But?
Yes. Where are your suspicions leading, Jesse?
Jesse was definitely questioning Stampy the longest.
What? No!
Dan was in there way longer.
Hey, not cool.
Guys, come on.
Not sure.
I actually don't think there's evidence enough to accuse anyone yet.
What?
Yeah, that seems surprising.
I'm sorry, but I don't want to accuse anyone unless I'm 100% sure. And I'm not.
Wow. Way to take a bold stance, Jesse.
Well, I, for one, am not comfortable being surrounded by possible killers. So if you'll excuse me, I'm going to barricade myself in the library for my own safety.
Fine, see
what
yourself.
About catch
yeah,
you
I'm more in the safety and numbers camp myself.
Well, that was certainly some excitement.
Yeah, no kidding.
If the White Pumpkin is still roaming around, though, he might be trying to set up more traps. We need to figure out how these things work. Like, we know that the Sparkles trap was triggered by those buttons under the table, but what about the trap that turned Torque Dog into a pincushion? If we figure out how these things work, we might be able to find more proof about who the White Pumpkin is, how they're operating.
Petra's
I'm not sure, but the White Pumpkin didn't trigger it until Torque Dog was in the exact right spot. That means he must have been watching from somewhere.
Creepy.
Yes. Seems like it might be worth our while to poke around the kitchen.
You guys go on ahead. I'm gonna stay here, keep an eye on these other people. I don't want them trying anything when we're not looking.
Thanks, Lucas.
Back in the kitchen. So, what are we looking for exactly? Buttons like back in the dining room?
We just need more evidence. Anything that can draw a link to one of these people.
Got it. I'm on the lookout.
Hopper trap? What is this?
Huh. I wonder where Torque Dog's stuff went when it got sucked away.
And Sparkle's stuff, for that matter.
Does this painting have eye holes?
Oh, yeah. How'd I not notice that before?
Seems worth taking a closer inspection.
Oh! Just punched the shit out of it. Okay. God damn.
It's some sort of secret passageway. Very clever. What do you suppose that lever does?
Let's pull it.
Okay, everyone. Make sure you're nowhere near that arrow trap.
More of those potion-covered arrows. Nasty.
Well, seems like we found out how the White Pumpkin killed Torque Dog.
Yeah, and how he's getting around the house.
I assume we're investigating the creepy passageway?
I think we've gone too far to turn around now.
Exactly.
Well, after you then.
Killer instinct.
I hope Dan's okay locked up in the library. We could have put them in the...